Hey guys, how are you? All right, so something else we're going to do this month for February, to wrap up February, is another celebration of love type of thing. And we're going to make a little art doll to commemorate maybe somebody special in your life who's no longer with us. In my case, this whole week I've been commemorating my grandmother, and I would normally say I'm not exactly sure why, but I actually do know why. Her funeral was on February 14th, not this year, it was a few years ago. So we're going to take, I want to really take these off of here so I can use it better. So we're going to take some more of her house coat, and we're going to make a little art doll. And I have another piece of the sleeve here, and this is an art doll pattern. It's a pattern of mine. It is already available over in my Facebook group, A Life of Art and Self-Expression. If you are not a member there, I also am going to put it over in the My Year 2017 Facebook group. So if you're not into one in one of those groups, and you want to be, the links are in the description below. I will try to remember to put a link to a Dropbox. That pen's not going to work. To a Dropbox that you guys can access to download the pattern in the description below. If I forget, somebody like write something and remind me, because it would be very like me to just forget. So this is one of the doll bodies. There's three shapes of doll bodies. And I'm going to just trace around it roughly with a pen. And then cut it out. I should be using fabric scissors for this, but, you know, I'm not. So while I'm cutting it out, I'm going to try to either cut right on the black line or cut the black line off. At least that's my intention anyway. I don't know. We'll see how if I accomplish it. You could do this with, you know, an old vintage piece of fabric, a piece of hand. I make these and sell them in my shop out of handmade fabric, hand painted, like you see is happening to my drop cloth here. You can make them out of felt, whatever you have laying around. Okay, so now we have and I've cut it wrong sides together, so I have two pieces of fabric. Now I wanna make a face. And I think I'm going to use this piece of canvas for the face. I'm gonna whack off, this is just a scrap of canvas that I have. I'm gonna whack off a square that's about the right size, and then I'm gonna cut an oval out of it. Yep, and that'll work. So now before we do anything else, let's zoom in. You're gonna need to see this. So we're gonna make our face. Now you could draw your face, you could paint the face. I am actually going to embroider the face. And I know you're all like going, what? Oh, seriously, you guys can do this. I'm going to grab one of these embroidery needles. Of course, the one I want's in the middle because... Okay, well, I got three. I don't need three. I do have this little Altoids tin that I should just stick these needles in. Okay. I am going to use black and red thread. This is kind of an orangey red, but that's okay. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take my pen very lightly, or pencil, and I'm going to sketch out a simple closed eye face. Now, you could do this in Sharpie and then leave it at that. Little nose, and then a heart for the mouth. Just like that, okay? Then we're gonna take some of our black thread first. And I usually use, I need my glasses. You could also probably stitch this on the sewing machine, but it's pretty teeny. It'd be easier to do it by hand. I'm going to separate my floss so I just have two strands. If you're not familiar with embroidery floss, it's a six-stranded, basically a piece of string. Embroidery floss is really great to like do hand-bound books with and stuff like that. And of course the traditional embroidery. Okay. So we're going to just do a running stitch. So I'm going to start at one end of the eyelashes, or the eye. Oop, I should tie a knot back here. That would be handy. Okay, let's start at one end and then go over just a little bit. I don't know, like an eighth of an inch. Then go and bring the needle back up about an eighth of an inch from where you did the first stitch and go up. And then go back into that hole where the first stitch is. Just like that. Okay, I'm going to do it again. It doesn't matter what the back looks like because we're going to sew this to the other fabric. So if your back is messy, it doesn't matter. I am not the neatest embroiderer in the world. My grandmother was always trying to tell me to, you know, that the back should be as neat as the front. And she's not wrong. I just was never able to accomplish that. Okay, so then I'm going to come back over here. And I'm just going to have my thread travel on the back. But it's not going to show on the front. And I'm going to come up at the bottom of this first little eyelash. Maybe. Or at least close to it. There we go. And then I'm going to go down at the base of those stitches that I just put in to make one of the eyelashes. And I'm going to do that two more times. And I'll show you what I mean about the back being messy because it's, I can feel it. I don't think it's very neat. My backs generally are not neat. And if you use a thin pen or pencil, then the embroidery floss should cover up all of it. So then when you're done, turn it over and tie a knot. And pull. And then I'm going to do it again. And then trim. So the back is kind of messy. Whoop. There we go. But the front looks good. So let's do the other eye. Might have just enough floss to do the other eye. Make sure I'm on camera. I would recommend stitching it out. You also could use a water-soluble pen in your fabric department and probably your embroidery department of your store. They probably have a fabric marking pen that's water soluble, and you can get one of those and use that to do your markings. And then after you do your embroidery, you just get it wet and the pen disappears. I do have one of those around here somewhere. I didn't feel like searching for it, to be real honest. Okay. And we're going to come back and do our eyelashes. Cute. She's already looking cute. Okay. Tie knot. Oops. And I don't think we have enough on here to do the nose, so we'll just grab another piece because it's not like I have any shortage of embroidery floss around here. I used to do a lot more embroidery than I do now. I should probably purge some floss. Okay. So I'm going to use black for the nose also. And then we'll use this red color for the lips. And we're going to do the nose and a chain running stitch also. Just the trick is to not have your stitches be too big. Have them, you know, be kind of little. There we go. The lips I do generally a little bit differently, and I'll show you what I mean by that. I'm okay with the edges of this fray. If you're not, you might want to stitch it down or use a piece of flesh colored felt for this instead of like a canvas. So now we're going to take a little piece of our red. And again, we're going to separate it and pull out just two. Where are you? There you are. Just two. It's multi-stranded here. So we're going to just pull out two. Oops. Two threads. Oops. The hardest part some days is threading the needle, I swear. There we go. Got it. Okay, we're going to tie a little knot in the end. Okay, we're going to come up at the base of the little heart shape that we have for the mouth. And I'm not doing a heart-shaped mouth just because it's February. We're doing this for the month of February. I always do, almost always do a heart-shaped mouth. So I'm going to come up at the base and then I'm going to make a loop and go down at the base. But when I pull, I'm going to hold this loop down and I'm only going to pull it until it's about the same size as that pen mark that I made. Then I'm going to come up at the top of the loop, or the top of the pen mark. There we go. Catch the loop. Try to have it not be too tight. And then you want to go down in the loop in the same place and arrange that loop so it looks like that. So you have a little chain stitch. And then we're going to do it again. We're going to come back up in the same place in the base where the other stitches are coming out of. And then back down there. And then come up in the top of this other side of this heart shape for the mouth. About there. Grab that loop. And back down in the same place. Pull it snug, but not too tight. That was a little bit too tight. There we go. And then just tie it in a knot. Tying it in a knot's the hardest part. Okay. So once you have that done, then your face should look something like this. You can adjust your little mouth loops so they actually form a kind of a heart shape if they get all cattywampus in the assembly, you know, embroidery process. You can, of course, do your running stitch all around the mouth if you would prefer. But I kind of like the way that the heart, little heart shape looks on the mouth. All right, so now I have this piece of lace from something else that we did this month that I think I want to put behind the face. We're going to take one part of the body, not both. Set the other one aside. And yeah, I think I want to put this lace like across the head with the face in the middle. I have this trim that I painted that I think I want to put around the edge of the face. Okay, so we're gonna let's put some of this stuff aside that way. All right, so we've got the little sewing machine out. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna stitch this across here. And the stitching doesn't have to be perfect, and you could probably glue it if you would prefer. My sewing right now because I sewed something really thick on it the other day. Okay, and then I want to take our little face and see if we can sew this around it. Let's see if we can. On this machine, we'll see if we can. Let's do a little zigzag because I think that would be easier. Nope, see, it's not wanting to. Let's see. Let me see if I can get this on here. I'll be back.
Okay.
So I sewed the face down without the trim on it because I think we're going to have to glue the trim on, and I don't think it's going to, I could break out my other machine and get out a fancy presser foot to sew it on, but most of you out there are not going to be able to do that and have, I know some of you don't have those kind of sewing skills, so we're not going to do that. You could hand stitch it on. I just trimmed off the excess lace. And all of this here is garbage. Okay. So we're gonna trim off this little raggedy old piece where I was trying to sew it on and get that off of there. Okay. I do think I want this on here though. Before we do anything else, I think I want to put a little heart on here. So I could do it with felt. I could do it with fabric, ribbon. Let's see. Do we want it to be pink? Do we want it to be paper? It could be paper. It could be a paper heart. Why couldn't it be paper? This is a little mixed media doll. I have this pretty handmade paper, red paper. This is just a scrap, hasn't been thrown away yet. Let's use this. So let's cut out a shape, a heart shape. There we go. I want to cut a white one too. And I think I want to layer them. Or do I want to use fabric? Oh, choices, people, choices. It's too many choices. I have more of the canvas. I could use a little piece of canvas. The canvas might be fun. Let's use the same piece of canvas that we used before. Yep. So let's... Okay, my camera battery died. I don't know where I left off, but I took a little scrap of red fabric, cut it into a heart shape, and sewed it to a red fabric, red paper, sewed it to another scrap of the canvas. And we're going to sew that to the front of our doll now. We're still just working with a single layer of fabric. Okay, A little trouble with the bobbin tangling. All right. So before you do anything else, you want to make sure that you have all the decorations that you want to machine sew to the front of your doll on here before you do anything else. If you're not the kind of person that likes the raw frayed edge look, then you're going to want to like hem things. Honestly, this is a little art doll and I wouldn't be bothered, but that's totally up to you. It's your doll. So now I'm going to layer my two pieces, one on top of the other, so that the edges all match. I want to get a little piece of scrap ribbon or lace, use what you have. I might want to use a little piece of, I have lots of choices, but I have this like seam, what is it? Seam binding. And I think I want to just use a little piece of this. I'm going to need one piece for the top and I'm going to need a longer piece for the bottom. Okay, so the piece for the top folded in half. Put the cut ends inside your doll. And leave the loop out so that you have a loop to hang it by, whether you're hanging it on a bulletin board or something else. We're going to need some pins. I'm going to pin that in place. Okay. For the bottom, we're going to put the cut ends out and put the folded piece in. And pin that in place. We're going to sew and we're going to leave a little bit of an opening on one side and we're going to sew around the rest of the doll. So I'm going to do that and I'll be right back. So I like the way the messy, grungy two rows of stitches looks. If that's not for you, again, you might want to do this a different way. I'm going to take a little bit of stuffing, polyester batting, and I left an opening that's about 1.5 inches, 2 inches big right here. It's about 1.5 inches. I don't think that's 2 inches. And I'm going to just gently put some of the stuffing inside of my doll. I'm going to push it up to the head first. I don't want it to be too full and puffy. It doesn't need to be. And then the other, the body and the neck. Oh, got a piece of thread in there. That's okay. Now on the art dolls I sell, I put, you know, protection stones and things inside the doll. I'm not going to here, but you could. Or you could put, maybe you've got, if it's a remembrance piece, maybe you've got a funeral card, you want to fold it up and stick it inside the doll or something like that. You could totally do that. So now I'm going to just quickly stitch the hole closed. I'm going to stop at the other end and I'm going to actually lift up the presser foot, turn the doll around, and do another row of stitching. So that the hole looks the same as the rest of the edge of the doll. So there's two rows of stitching all the way around. So that's how our doll looks so far. Isn't she cute? I like her. Alright, I'm going to move this up out of the way, put the pins away. All right, so this is how she looks so far, and I still am thinking I want to put this around her head, maybe. I don't know now that I have her together, maybe I don't want to put that on. Maybe I want to put it like here. Maybe. That would work. Let's get out the little other bits and pieces I want to put on here. So this is exactly how I got it from my grandmother, how it was found among her things in this Amoretti chocolates box. And my grandmother was very philanthropic and very Catholic. And she gave to Catholic charities on a regular basis, and every time she did, they gave her Catholic medallions. And this is one of two boxes that I have like this, full, like you can see, it's very full. So we're going to take a few of these fun things in here, and there's some keychains and other things in here. And what I want to do is I want to put some of them on the bottom of the doll and dangle them from the bottom of the doll. She also gave to the Olympics and other charities. There's a lot of stuff in here. Oh, look at that, a dream catcher. That might need to go at the bottom of the doll. And there's an angel. So let me dig through here and let me, oh, there's a St. Anthony. Let me find some things to hang from the bottom of our doll, some charms and medallions and things from my grandmother's stash of things. And I will be right back. Okay, I'm gonna zoom in a bit. So I got a couple of like charm dangles made from the things I found in my grandmother's box. I'm gonna hang them from the bottom of the doll, just real easily by just honestly stringing them on the ribbon and then tying it in a knot. Nothing complicated. You could color this seam binding with inks or paint. You can get this seam binding at your fabric store, I believe, but I ordered a big spool of it from Amazon kind of a long time ago. And I love that. I did find some interesting things in here, and I have another box of these, which I haven't looked at yet, but evidently my grandmother gave on a fairly regular basis to Habitat for Humanity, these ones with little houses in them are from Habitat for Humanity, and they say, bless this house on one side. And then this one, which is the exact same size and feels like it's made out of the same metal, is from the Christopher Reeve Foundation, Paralysis Foundation. So that's interesting. I found this little thing which says record and detach. Well, I don't know what that is. I found this little medallion, which does, it may be inexpensive metal, but it feels like some kind of different kind of inexpensive metal. And it says Bambino on the back, which is Italian for baby. And there's some other words I can't quite make out. Maybe Protecta? I don't know. I can't quite make it out. So she has that one. And there's the back. The most interesting one, does anybody know what this is? Was in the bottom of her box. I don't know what that is. And it looks like this on the back. It appears to be copper. So I don't know what that is. So that's interesting. That's in the bottom of Grandma's box. I don't know what they're in there, what they are. These things, I know what these are. These are for saying the rosary. If you don't, you know, this is a different way of saying the rosary rather than carrying around a full a set of rosary beads. There's a couple of these. I have quite a few of these from her stash of stuff. So here's our doll. I'm still trying to figure out. I'm still thinking I want to put this on here. I'm just trying to think of how I want it on here. Or should it even be on here? I'm kind of thinking maybe it shouldn't even be on there now because I kind of like the way she's looking just like this. So let me clean up and put things away and I'll think about it and I'll be right back. Okay, I decided to give her wings. I know, right? You're like, wings, wait a minute. It just seems fitting. So I'm going to take some more of this red paper and I cut some more heart shapes out. I'm just using, again, the Elmer's Extreme glue. Aileen's Tacky glue would work. Okay, and then I'm going to just eyeball it. Yeah, that looks about right. I'm going to need the pokey tool again. And this is what we're going to do. We're going to poke two holes in the card. This is a piece of cardboard box that I ripped and distressed. And I'm going to just poke two holes. Okay. I'm going to use some of this baker's twine. which is now knotted because I'm terrible with baker's twine. All right, I'm gonna whack off a piece. I'm gonna use this bookbinding needle because it's nice and long. Why am I threading this with my glasses on? I have no idea. Okay, that's better. I can actually see what I'm doing. Doesn't help me get it done, but I can see that I'm missing. There we go. Yay! All right. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in one side, and I'm going to go into the back of the doll's neck and out, I don't know, about a half an inch down. Pull. Flip the rings around. Go out the other hole. The reason I'm doing this and not gluing is because I think this will hold it better. You could put some glue back there too if you wanted. And then just tie it in a knot. Okay. Trim. Yep, that's cute. Cute, cute. Ooh, I love her. All right, I want to see if we can distress the edges of this by just, yep, pulling. I want to make these a little, actually, I'm going to make this one shorter. And pull. I want them to be different lengths. Again, you could if you don't want, you know, if you have white seam binding and you want it to be like red or blue, you could use some ink or stains or something, and it, you could color it that way. There we go. Ha. Yep. Oh, she's super cute. All right, let me zoom out. She is super cute. I'm going to enjoy having her in my office, a remembrance to my grandmother. So think about this as we wrap up this month of love, this month of February, taking some bits and pieces that you're hoarding in your art room or your house or your life and creating, instead of storing them away in a box that nobody ever looks in, take them out and create something that can be out every day that you can look at, touch, and feel, and remember that person by. Like this little art doll, super cute. All right, that's it for today. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe if you can. And if you're not a part of my year 2017, which is what I created this doll for, then think about joining. It's a Facebook group. And maybe even think about supporting my YouTube channel here by shopping in my Etsy shop. The links for all of those are in the description below. But this is a fun way to remember somebody you love, and whether you do something like this as part of your journal or in addition to your journal for the year, this is a really fun thing to do and a great way to remember them and use up those bits and pieces. The most important thing, of course, is to go out and do something nice for yourself because you deserve it, and I'll see you later. Okay, bye guys.